Hello everyone, my name is Stephen Koppens and I'm a Senior Fast Track Solution Architect. Now that Synapse Link for Finance and Operations apps is in public preview, we wanted to provide some quick steps to get you started. During this session, when we look at setting up and configuring Synapse Link for Finance and Operations apps data on a Tier 2 environment, we're going to start by showing you a link to where the documentation can be found, followed by prerequisites. Next, we get into configuring the Synapse Link and then exporting tables. Finally, to round it off, we'll show you how you can make virtual entities visible and then enable track changes so that these can also be exported via Synapse Link, and then a little look at the navigation capabilities. The steps outlined in this session are documented on learn.microsoft.com. And you can access that information via the link shown to you on the screen. Also on learn.microsoft.com is information on how to set up the Azure Data Lake storage, which is used but not configured during this session. So for Synapse Link to work with finance and operations apps, you must be on version 10.0.34 or higher. You need to go into the license configuration or configuration keys and enable SQL row version change tracking preview. You need to have a linked Power Platform environment. And for our example, we've already set up an storage account. We've created an Azure Synapse workspace, and we have set up a Spark pool for Delta Lake data conversion job. Next step is to configure the Synapse Link and start exporting entities. Now we want to set up our Synapse Link. Now, to do this, we again go to the Maker portal, or we start at the Maker portal, and we want to find the Synapse Link. A shortcut. To do this, we click on More, and we go down to Discover All. And then if we go down, we can see Synapse Link. We can actually pin this for future reference, and then we click on it. And when the Synapse link page first opens up, because we haven't got anything configured, it'll give us the option to set up the initial link. So we click on New Link. And we've already set up the Synapse Analytics workspace. So we'll select the first option. And then we put in the resource group that we've already set up. And the system automatically detects the workspace name that's available. And then in this case, again, we created a Spark pool for Delta Lake data conversion. So we're going to select that option, and it automatically defaults the Spark pool that I created. The storage account, again, defaults through. And then for this particular scenario, I'm going to select the enterprise policy with managed service identity. All that remains is then to select the entities you wish to export to the data lake. Now, in subsequent sessions, we'll see how you make the finance and operations apps entities visible. But once you have made them visible, you can find them by using the prefix MSERP. Then once you've selected them, you sit back and wait for them to synchronize. The next area we want to look at is exporting the tables from finance operations apps. In order to do this, we need to edit the query string. This is only required during the preview. So on the end of the URL, we need to type in the question mark athena.enable FNO tables equals true. Once you've done that, you can hit enter and wait for the screen to refresh. Once the screen has refreshed, we're able to again go into our storage account. And once that loads, we can click on Manage Tables again. But this time, when the Manage Tables form loads, you'll notice that there's D365 Finance and Operations. These are the tables that are available to export via Synapse Link. And here you can search for any of the tables. So in this case, I'm searching for Invent Table, and I'm selecting the table and clicking on Save. And that's everything you need to do. So now that is beginning to sync the data from Finance and Operations to the data lake using Synapse Link. And once that has initialized, you can see now on the right-hand side, the entity source, and it says FNO tables. So you've already seen that we can set up and configure tables to be exported via Synapse Link. However, if you would like to go further and look at exporting entities to the Synapse Link, the next step's about showing how to make those entities visible and then turning on track changes can be followed. To make finance and operations entities visible in the Synapse Link, we need to click on the cogs icon from the Makers portal and then click on Advanced Settings. This brings up the form from which we then go and click on the advanced filter icon, which again is in the top right-hand corner. This enables us the ability to actually search for the entities that we want to be able to see within Synapse Link. We do this by first looking for the available finance and operations entities in the look for field. So after we've selected that, we're actually able to refine the search criteria. And we do that by, for example, specifying what field we want to filter by, and in this case, we'll use name. And then we look at the various criteria we want to use for searching. So in this case, we're going to say that it ends with BI entity. And then once we've specified that filter criteria, we can click on the results icon, which will execute the query for us. Once this is completed running, it will return all of the entities that meet that criteria within finance operations that are available for us. Then we go and select the entity that we're interested in making available, and we change the field visibility from no or false to yes. So once this is loaded, we select visible. And once we've selected that and enabled it, we click on save and close. This then goes away and it's now making that particular entity visible. This is done because there's so many entities available in finance and operations that by default, we don't make them all visible. So now if you want to go, we can refresh this particular screen and you'll see that it changes from visible equals no to visible equals yes. Now we're just going to look at how you can enable track changes for these entities. To do that, we again go to the Maker portal and we click on tables. This will show us all of the most common database tables initially. So these are the recommended ones, and then you should click on custom. And if you've got custom tables, you can see them there. And then of course, all. Now, in order to find the entities from FNO, we're going to type in MSERP in the search icon. And here are our entities that we've made available, visible. And then what we do is we select one, click on properties, and then scroll to advanced options and find track changes, which we then enable and click on save. Once that's completed, you repeat that process for the other entities and you're good to go. And finally, for today, we will look at navigation for accessing the data that has been exported. So again, we'll start from the Maker portal and we'll click on the Azure Synapse Link, which again takes us to the page where we can now select the storage account we want to look at. And then you'll notice some buttons at the top. So the first one we're going to click on is go to Azure Data Lake. And this takes us to our storage account and we can look at the containers and we can see the containers where all of the data from via Synapse Link is being exported to. And we can see the Data Lake formats as well. One of the other buttons is the go to the workspace, Azure Synapse workspace. So let's open up this one, and this takes us directly to our Synapse workspace. Okay. And from here, again, you can access the tables and the data that's been exported. And you can start using that information.
And the last link or button is go to Spark Pool, which we also set up and configured to convert the information into Delta Lake format. And here you can just see the history of the jobs and any information about the Spark Pool that you might want to research. Thank you for your time today.